For a very long time, experts in the study of fish and marine creatures, as well as fishermen and people living near the shore, have noticed a very strange phenomenon for which they could not find any explanation. They would find fish with circular or dugout holes in their bodies, sometimes with more than 20 holes in a single fish. Some of these fish were found in the water, but some were found washed up on the shore. These circular patterns were also found etched on the bodies of larger fish, such as dolphins or even sharks. Hello, I'm Davis. But before we begin, if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you receive our videos as soon as they are released. Please make a hole in the red button below. The cute creature in front of you in the picture is the lamprey. At first glance, if you look at it from above, you may think it is an ordinary sea creature that resembles eels, and you may even think it is cute and peaceful. However, once you look at it from below, specifically the lower part of its mouth, you will see its terrifying appearance. The lamprey, or stone sucker, is a type of marine animal belonging to the class of jawless fish. Its length ranges from 13 centimeters to 1 meter. The structure of this creature is extremely simple. Its entire body is made up of cartilage and has no bones at all. It does not have fins like fish, and even its body has no scales. Its movement is slow, and it has only one nostril opening and 7 respiratory openings on each side, which it uses like gills. Despite all this, the lamprey has a deadly weapon that it relies on for almost everything in its life, and it is considered the main reason for the lamprey's survival to this day. Especially when you realize that the lamprey, despite its modest abilities, has been present on Earth for more than 360 million years. The lamprey has a round mouth that contains dozens, if not hundreds, of sharp teeth made of keratin and proteins. In the center of these teeth, there is a pointed tongue made up of 3 parts that acts like a drill. Additionally, the outer frame of the mouth is very soft, which allows the lamprey to attach to any surface, similar to a suction cup or a pelvic sucker. The unique structure of its mouth enables the lamprey to stick or clamp onto any surface so tightly that it can even attach to rocks. The lamprey is often seen hanging on a cliff with its mouth attached, while its body floats in the water. This is why the lamprey is known as a rock sucker. However, with a mouth like that, the lamprey does not rely solely on clamping onto rocks. It also attacks any fish that comes in front of it, such as salmon, trout, and others. Once the lamprey detects a fish, it jumps on it and clamps onto its body. However, no matter how hard the fish tries to escape, moving left or right, it fails in all attempts. The lamprey uses its pointed tongue to penetrate the fish's body. Once the tongue reaches the flesh, it creates an opening and begins to suck the blood and fluids from the fish's body. During this process, the lamprey secretes anticoagulants and other substances to prevent blood clotting and to allow it to draw out as much as it wants, similar to the mechanism used by mosquitoes and flies, but on a larger scale. After finishing its task, the lamprey detaches from the fish and swims away, leaving the fish's body covered in deep circular wounds that can lead to its death. Even if the fish manages to survive, it loses a significant amount of weight and its activity decreases due to the inflammation and infection that occurs at the site of the wound. What's amazing is that this strange animal doesn't settle for small fish or even large fish. The lamprey attacks massive creatures like dolphins, sharks, and even whales, clamping onto them and sucking their blood and fluids. There have been numerous reports of dolphins and sharks with circular bruises on their bodies caused by lamprey bites. The same is true for whales. In 1950, researchers examining a group of whales on the coast of Vancouver Island in Canada noticed signs of lamprey teeth on the bodies of massive whales such as humpback, gray, and even fin whales, which, by the way, are the second largest whale in the world after the blue whale. So, the lamprey, despite its small size, is a force to be reckoned with. The difference between lamprey attacks on large marine creatures and small fish is that the wounds inflicted on large creatures heal rapidly, allowing them to recover quickly from the lamprey's attack. However, researchers have also found hollow circular marks on the bodies of sharks, dolphins, and whales that are much larger than those caused by the lamprey, and the wounds are deeper, to the extent that some dolphins have even died from these injuries. This suggests that there may be another, much larger, and more aggressive marine creature that attacks in a similar way to the lamprey. If the appearance of a lamprey is scary to you, let me introduce you to the cookiecutter shark. This animal looks so strange that you might imagine it as a mythical creature from a movie, but it is actually a type of small shark. The cookiecutter shark's average length ranges from only 42 to 56 centimeters. Despite its small size, it has very peculiar physical characteristics. This shark has 37 teeth in its upper jaw, which are small and sharp triangles, and 31 teeth in its lower jaw, also in the form of sharp triangles. However, these teeth are not separate like those of other sharks. Instead, they are connected to each other forming a single structure, resembling a saw-shaped dental set. This shark's teeth are not replaced individually, but rather, the entire set of teeth is renewed at once. When a new set of teeth grows, the old set is swallowed and digested by the shark to obtain calcium and other nutrients. Imagine a shark that eats its own teeth. This gives you an idea of how fierce this creature can be. Another important feature of the cookiecutter shark is that its skin emits a glow of specific wavelengths that attracts larger fish to the area as if it is a trap. As soon as a fish approaches the area, the shark attacks it immediately, takes a chunk of flesh, and disappears. The wound it leaves on the prey's body is circular and deep, resembling a cookie, which is why scientists named it the cookiecutter shark. Researchers who studied the behavior of the cookiecutter shark discovered that it attacks any marine creature in its environment, regardless of its size. They have documented cookiecutter shark bites on dolphins, whales, sharks, and even fast-swimming fish such as marlin fish. Therefore, there is no escape from this shark as long as you move in the water. That's all for now. If you enjoyed this information, please leave a like before you go. Also, don't forget to suggest any topic you would like to know more about in the comments. We take most of our ideas from your suggestions. Goodbye.